Something has just moved in there. And I'm trying not to react to it. I am just a regular feller out here looking for mushrooms. Which I think if I see any chanterelles, I will pick them. You can see where the deer have been coming up. Look, that's all deer tracks coming up in here. Look at this big mound of dirt. It must be a Bigfoot burial ground. I'm kidding. But there is like a little structure here, and that blind up there, this is a deer trail coming up. That could be a booger blind. There's more down here. More booger blinds. I see something move down here. It's pretty far down through there. Could have been anything. But where I'm at right now, I'm thinking is where they could be at, because this is one of the, not the next stop from where I had my sighting, but the stop after that. You see, my theory is they move around, they have to, so the food doesn't get exhausted. You know, if you overhunt an area, not only will the deer catch on to you, but also, if you are very successful, you're going to hunt out all the deer and they won't be there anymore because you've eaten them all. So they move around and they have, I guess, what you might call a base camp in different places. I think they send an advanced sentry out, or two or three. I'm now estimating that the Rude Fork clan is at least 8 members strong now. I found the 5 different tracks, plus 2 more. I knew about more tracks, but who knows? I found the 5 at once. All right, so you include all those. And they weren't the biggest tracks. And I've yet to find the big alpha male track yet on my property or around here. The biggest one I ever found was 17 inches. And it wasn't here. I've also talked to people in the know and where the game is plentiful around here, and there's other signs that I'm not going to mention. But there might be a couple of clans around here. There might be different individuals, the lone male. I just heard a thump. For anybody that wants to get out and do this, a good technique is to use the steel hunt, which is what a lot of deer hunters do. I do it myself from time to time, but the activity, the deer hunting slow. But on a steel hunt, you can take a few steps. You can do it different ways. I usually take 1 to 2 steps and stop and just look. But while boogering, I'll take up to, you know, a dozen steps and stop. And if they're around, you can catch them up making noises. They actually use your noise to cover for their noises. Like I said before, I'm not a professional or an expert. Dog or something. And I always forget something whenever I come out to do some boogering. And on this adventure, I forgot my bug spray. I usually keep some with me, but I took it out of the side-by-side to spray myself down before I went in the garden. I probably got 6 cans of this stuff. And I try to keep one. Man, God, I'm hung up in a briar. I try to keep one, like, on the side-by-side four-wheeler. Just look how thick the deer have been in here. I mean, that's old. That's a couple days old. But they're in here. And where you find deer, you're going to find boogers. I haven't seen any type of booger tracks yet. But I haven't actually reached the corridor, the main part of the route. And that's not to say that they don't come here. I know they do. I know they've been here before. Down here is where that one growled at me. This is a pretty nice ridge line. It's got like a gentle rise to it on both sides. And I also think boogers take advantage of that too. And we'll do what I'm doing right now. I'll walk. Well, probably a little bit further down below there. I know they do on this other side, but it's, I'm telling y'all, it's freaking thick in there. Not gonna make for very good film. What is that? I'm trying to walk out to this point. I've got something moving around down here below me. And that's part of their route down there. I haven't been this far down the ridge line in a while. I'm up top here. Probably since I was in my 20s. Many moons ago. But it's looking good. It's getting a lot thicker. I just caught a whiff of something too. Nice smell. coming from this way, the areas. It looks like another kill box right here. Or, I like to call it a corral. Because it's like they set this stuff up to focus the game in a certain direction. And then they'll build them a blind, and whenever the deer or turkey or whatever it happens to be gets there, they can jump out and give them a big old hug. Check this stick out. Oh, it looks like it's been chewed. Well, maybe it just broke. It ain't chewed. But then laid on top of this. Oh, wow, this is beautiful. There's an old track. Measure that one because that's a pretty nice size one. But look at these old rock cliffs and stuff that they can get under down here. It's about 15 inches. That's a pretty decent size. I feel like I'm being looked at right now. I'm going to ease on out this way. That way we can look back up this holler some. There's a break right there too. There's another track right there. It looks like it's coming out this way. And I just wonder about logs like this. I mean, where did that come from? Yeah, this is soft right here where I'm at now. It's all good topsoil. I don't see no root ball for that log. And I wonder if it's like a ladder for them to get up here. Right there would be a great place to see it. And you got command over all this holler. There's another down tree over here going up on that rock. You got this old burnout stump right here. But, man, I really, that could have come from that. I don't know. I guess it's possible. Something's moving around down there. But look, that's the perfect place to see it. Get your back up in that log. You got covering behind you. Something is definitely moving around down there. I've heard a couple snaps. A deer, hog, or whatever would have been gone by now. So much noise as I've made. I watch out for snakes here too. Let me get through here and I'll start another video.